This is WKTV Journal. I'm Ken Norris. In focus today is Kent County's change to new voting machines coming later this year. We are here with Lisa Posthumus Lyons, Kent County Clerk and Register of Deeds, who was elected to the position in November after serving three terms in the state legislature. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you, Ken. I'm so glad to be here.
Very good. So we will have new voting machines throughout the county starting in November.
That's correct. The entire state of Michigan is transitioning to new election equipment, and Kent County's implementation will be ready for the first elections with the new system coming this November for those areas that have an election.
Okay. And so tell us a little about the process. Well, first tell us a little about the need for new machines and then the selection process.
Sure. This has really been a long time coming. It started several years back. The current system that we have in Kent County and actually statewide, we've had since 2004. And so these machines are, you know, they're becoming dated, antiquated, they're becoming more and more frequently in need of repair, and we want to make sure that we are, that election day runs smoothly both for our election workers, but mostly for our voters. And the time has come where we have to invest in our equipment to make sure that our elections are run without a hitch. So that's where we've got the need for them. And the process has been very fascinating. Like I said, a long time coming. It started several years ago where the state put together a joint evaluation committee, which my elections director, Sue DeSteiger, very reputable, very well known, I think the world of her, she actually sat on that committee where they took in bids from vendors wishing to provide election equipment service to the counties in the state, and those were met with much review and testing and demonstration to meet certification requirements both at the federal level but also at the state level. So it's been an arduous process, and then once the state narrowed the vendors down to three, mm-hmm. that would qualify, the county clerk then each county clerk in the state had the task then of selecting what system would best work for their individual county.
Okay, so there may be different machines in different counties throughout the state. Is
that's
that correct?
That's correct. Yep.
So the ones that we are going to have here through the new machines through Dominion Voting Systems, and which is a national supplier, and their software service provider, Election Source, which I understand is located here in Kent County. You have said before that was important to you for them being out of Kent County. Give me a little rationale for that.
There were a tremendous amount of factors and variables that I weighed as we went through the process. Significant input from our local clerks on the ground in the municipalities. You know, we did demonstrations with each of the equipment for those clerks, those local clerks, to be able to get a hands-on idea of what's being offered and what might work best in Kent County or their municipality. So really, it was with the input from the clerks, kind of the cost was a factor as well. In some regards, but not the factor, because what really mattered was service.
Right.
Because I wanted to make sure that we have a election equipment provider that is reputable. They have demonstrated, proven over and over again that they run that their equipment allows for quality elections, and I wanted to make sure that that we had the input of the locals, because they're the ones that are going to have to, on the ground on election day, work with our service providers and those kind of things. So I wanted quality, and I wanted service. And Dominion, kind of for me, heads above the rest in that reputation, combined with the solid reputation throughout the state that Election Source has in working with our local clerks and being responsive and providing good quality service. And frankly, I really believe that the fact that we as a county with our system we are able to support our local business right here in our own backyard. That was just icing on the cake.
Mm-hmm. So this was really one of your first major decisions, I assume, in taking your new position in November?
That's correct. I was elected in November and took office this past January.
Right.
And by April was the time frame we were given, the deadline if we wanted to implement in November. That was the deadline that counties were given to have that their provider selected. Just because I'm new to the county clerk's role, fortunately, I feel like I came in with a little bit of an advantage because I wasn't new to this issue. Being when I was in the Michigan House the last 4 years, I served as chair of the Elections Committee, the House Elections Committee. And so we knew that this was an issue that was about to take place because it had been kind of kicked off during that time. And so I worked to pass a law that would make sure that we maintained local control in this process to ensure that each local clerk or each county clerk has had the ability to select the equipment versus having a statewide one size fits all provider. So I certainly wasn't new to the issue, though it was a very it was a quick study.
Right. So the new machines, how will they look to the public, what will be familiar, what might be a little new?
Well, first, voters can take heart that we will continue to cast our ballots on a paper ballot that will be fed into an optical scan tabulator. So the voters, I don't think, will notice too shocking of a change here. So I like that we've got some familiarity. It won't be kind of this shock when voters come in where they don't know what they're looking at. Very, very similar to what they're used to in terms of how they vote, what they do to cast their ballot. But it's just, it's more innovative. It's more technologically advanced. For example, when a voter feeds their ballot into the machine, and there's an error, it will tell the voter what the error was so that they can make a correction on a new ballot and make sure their vote counts the way they wanted it to count.
Very good.
So yeah, we're very excited. Our software on the back end will continue to operate our elections outside of an internet connection, which I think is very important in this age and making sure that our elections are secure and safe. So there won't be a large amount of changes in that regard, just updating and more confidence in a new system and more user friendly.
Very good. And you've touched on and maybe even answered my final question. It'd be, so somebody from the public walks up and says, is Kent County's voting system secure? Give them confidence. What would you say to them?
Kent County's voting process is absolutely, it is secure. The way Michigan is set up, we're kind of hack-proof because again, we have a paper ballot. We're casting our ballots into machines that are not connected to the internet. And again, with the blessing of being a home rule state, it's so decentralized. You have so many precincts operating that certainly it's a secure process on election day. But then going forward, even more so, as I've seen conducting audits from this past May, going through the canvas, the county canvassers to kind of reconcile to make sure all of the numbers add up and are balanced. I'm very confident in the security of our elections. Integrity is another issue, and there's a difference. I think where things can potentially go wrong is making sure that we're maintaining the integrity of the elections, and we can easily do that by making sure that we are requiring people to show an ID to prove they are who they say they are before their ballot counts. But additionally, on my end, as an election administrator working with local clerks, making sure that we are adequately training the boots on the ground, those people who come and work the elections, you know, for 13 hours a day, 14 hours a day, making sure that they are trained, have the tools that they need to confidently know the process and what to expect. And those things combined, I believe we are top-notch in security and we can be top-notch in integrity as well.
Very good. Thank you very much for being with us today at WKTV and explaining this issue to us.
Thank you for having me. It was my pleasure.
Very good. This has been WKTV Journal In Focus. I'm Ken Norris. Thanks for joining us today.